heraldic sounds of nagari pipes and celebratory drums reverberated all over the world. The victorious soldiers marched, raising jubilant cries. Long live our beloved king, Maharaja Thiraja, Parameshwara, Konguni Muttanasa, Shri Purusha, Hail, Hail. It was the victorious march of the kind, just and valorous monarch, King Shri Purusha, who had defeated the armies of the enemy armies who had invaded the Pandyas, the Rashtrakutas, the Pallavas, who had been repeatedly attacking, invading the Ganga territories. The Gangavadi region was now safe. No one could now stand up to the might of Paramadi Shri Purusha. And here he was, in the capital city of Manyapura, riding on the back of his royal elephant. It looked as if the royal emblem itself had come alive. What a glorious sight it was. Shri Purusha means illustrious or extraordinary man. And can it ever happen that a kingdom ruled by such a significant personality do not breed exceptional men? Never. There he was, a boy named Kittayya, who was on the verge of metamorphosing into manhood, watching the splendid procession, awestruck and thrilled beyond words. He had come to Manyapura to see his brave soldier brother-in-law, Kammura, and also to celebrate in the victory, participate in the victory celebrations. And after seeing the king's splendid procession, a colorful dream filled his mind. I too want to become a brave soldier. Like my brave soldier brother-in-law, Kammura, I too want to fight heroically, win battles and get awards. I too want to gain recognition from our beloved king. That dream that sprouted as a thought in his mind took roots and grew into huge and unshakable ambition by the time he returned to his hometown, Perambodila Nadu. Once back home, he shared his dreams with his father. His father, the village administrator, was extremely happy and affectionately patted his back and said, "Very well, son. Yes, yes, why not?" The village administrator was indeed very glad, very proud of his son-in-law, Kammura, being an accomplished soldier. And he would certainly be even proud if his own son became an accomplished soldier and brought glory to their Kodandale clan. Every day, Kittayya only dreamt of becoming a soldier. Father's encouragement fueled his ambitions, and his glorious dream grew by leaps and bounds, day by day. One day, while sitting at home, he had just looked at the roof and dreamt about his life as a soldier. His mother came sweetly and said, "Oh son, what is this? Lost in thought again. Come, come, drink this porridge and take the cows to graze. Look, they are getting restless. Sada inge manorajya maadta kuntidre. ಮುಂದಿನ ಸಲ ದಂಡಿ ನಾಯ್ಕೆ ಕರೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ನಿನ್ ಕಳಿಸೋದಾದ್ರೂ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಅವ್ವ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಟು ದ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಮಿ ರೆಕ್ರೂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಸ್ಟೌಂಡೆಡ್ ಕಿತ್ತಯ್ಯ ಯೆಸ್ ಮೈ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಯೆಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಅ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಪೆರುನಗತ್ತರಸ ಟು ಸೆಂಡ್ ಯು ಟು ದ ರೆಕ್ರೂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಮಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಮಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಟಿಲ್ ದೆನ್ you leave your dreams aside in that basket and take the cows to graze, my dear son. Now, Gangavadi was a very huge territory, and for efficient administration, it was divided into smaller units, each under a governor appointed by the king. Now, this Peranagattarasa was in charge of Perambodila Nadu, where Kittayya and his family were living. A word to Peranagattarasa was as good as an appointment order, which Kittayya knew very well. His joy knew no bounds, and he immediately wanted to go and share this with his friends. So he drank the porridge, gathered his bow and his staff, and drove the cows to the pasture land. The pasture was on the banks of the freshwater body, Perambodila. There, Kittayya and his friends left the cows to graze in the grass, and they would sit under a huge old tree and chat about their dreams, their ambitions, their love for weaponry and idolizing soldiers. And all of his friends were extremely glad that Kittayya's dreams were soon going to be true. And then it so happened that Kittayya soon realized that it was not just dreams that is enough. He needed to be physically fit and train himself in all the weaponry techniques. Now, since Gangavadi was always under the threat of the enemy's armies invading into the kingdom, the Gangavadi army men had to be ever on alert. And so the expert military brothers named Perugundi and Tirugundi would make the soldiers do drills every day on the grounds. It was there when Kittayya saw them, watched them, and learned very keenly all the weaponry techniques from them and trained himself very, very rigorously. And he also taught all of these things to his friends, the exercises, spear throwing, sword fighting, shooting of arrows. Kittayya's parents were very proud to see his son working very hard and him growing muscular, fit and energetic day by day. And they would think that our son is going to make a wonderful soldier. And Kittayya would think, ah yes, when would that day arrive? I can't wait. One day, when Kittayya was sitting with his friends under the tree and snacking on some kajayas, a friend of his asked, Kittayya, when you become a soldier, will you leave the town and go? Will you leave us? To that, Kittayya clarified his doubt and said, no, never. Why should I? I will win the battle and return. Perapolanadu is my hometown. I will come back here. And they continued relishing on the snacks. Suddenly, there was a sharp sound of confusion. The boys startled up. Oh, our cows, their bells are jangling. Seems like they are in some panic. What is it now? Would it be a leopard or some wild boars? Kittayya leapt up the tree and crawled soon to the highest branch. There he looked around and saw a thick cloud of dust which was kicked by the rushing cows. Peering through those thick clouds, he could see some men appearing with spears and shields from behind a hillock, and behind them were barely visible some foot soldiers. Kittayya's heart skipped a beat. Ayyo, what is this? Who are they? Our kingdom has just sat down to rest after a war. And how are they sneaking in without anyone getting noticed about it? I must do something. And he jumped from the tree and he shouted at his friends who were bewildered and catching all the rushed, panicked cows. Hey, invaders, enemies, he said. Invaders? Okay, run. Yes, boys, you run. Go as soon as you can reach the town, go and alert everyone. Kittayya, are you not coming? No. I will keep a watch here. I will fight them off till our army arrives. But Kittayya, how is it possible? Everything is possible. The bow, the arrows, the spear and the baton, all of these are real. Given by my brave soldier brother-in-law Kamora, and I can fight. You please go. Don't waste your time. Go. And he leapt up again at the top of the tree. The boys, the cows rushed to the town and the people got alert. And soon the news of the invaders reached the army headquarters in no time. In the meantime, here in the pasture, Kittayya had already shot down a few soldiers who were coming nearer. As a flank of soldiers came nearer searching for the source of the arrows, Kittayya ferociously jumped from the tree with a howl. Just as the startled soldiers were preparing to fall upon him, Kittayya spun like a lightning. Turning his baton like a wheel, he cleared a space around him, daring anyone to come nearby. And if anyone came, they would be powerfully kicked in the stomach. They would stagger and fall. His long staff sliced across, disabling 3 to 4 at a time. Very soon, a battalion of Gangavadi army men reached the scene and they bashed and crashed on the Rattavadi men, the Rashtrakuta army men who had invaded. Seeing the Gangavadi army men having come, Kittayya was filled with energy and he fought with renewed vigor. Now furiously fighting, Kittayya noticed a approaching towards him with a drawn sword. Now Kittayya thought on his toes. He said, "Ha, now I have to attack this horse and then I can tackle this man very easily." And he positioned his bow and shot an arrow straight into the horse, and the arrow shot directly into the chest of the horse, and it crashed and threw the rider. But before it fell, the sword had already plunged into Kittayya. Kittayya, reacting instantly, sent his baton spinning onto the army, knocking him off, and Kittayya fell to the ground. Kittayya, the dreamer, became a martyr. The Gangavadi army men fought ferociously and they won the battle. It was a moment of pride, but the loss of this brave boy was unbearable to many of them. Peranagatarasa, the governor, carved and he inscribed a Veeragallu, which is called the hero's stone, and the military expert brothers, Perugundi and Tirugundi, installed the stone with all stately honors at the place most loved by Kittayya, the banks of Perabolalu or Pebolu or Pembala, which is now Hebbala. Well, to talk about this, the source of this story, this is a fictional story written by two sisters by name Chitra Ramachandran and Vidya Murali. The source of this story is a stone inscription belonging to the 8th century, which was discovered in Hebbal a year ago. So this stone inscription on the top half part is an image where a boy is holding a bow in his left hand and a short spear kind of a thing on his right hand, and there is a horse with a rider, and on the below part of the stone is a 5-line inscription written in Brahmi script and written in the language is old, very old Kannada, which has its roots from the main Dravidian language. And it's only those five lines, which is a succinct story of what could have happened. And from there, these sisters wrote the story to raise awareness, in an attempt to raise an awareness around conservation of our heritage, which is the inscription stones that we all have, that we have here in and around Bangalore. And why I chose this story was because Kittayya, the name Kittayya, is the earliest known name of a male resident in modern day Bengaluru. He can be regarded as the first male citizen of Bengaluru. And again, the story maybe could have happened this way, because it is installed in his memory of having sacrificed his life, being a martyr for saving the destruction of his homeland from